Welcome to Mastering Solutions. This is a projectile motion problem, and the question says that a ball with a horizontal speed of 1.25 meters per second rolls off of a bench 1 meter above the floor. So the initial horizontal velocity is 1.25 meters per second. It's going to have this sort of a trajectory here. It's going to roll off the edge of the bench and hit the floor right here. And we need to figure out two things. We need to figure out how long is it going to be in the air for, and then how far is this distance right here from the edge of the bench where it rolls off. So we need time, and we need to know a distance. We'll call it x final in the x direction. This is a good problem because they're guiding you through projectile motion problems, and this pattern is going to show up over and over and over and over. The initial x velocity, so we'll label this vi in the x, so the x component of the free fall problem here, is going to stay constant the entire time. So the x doesn't change. Once it leaves, it's going to keep going at 1.25 meters per second in the x direction. We know that the distance, they tell us, is 1 meter, but we'll say it's a negative 1 meter because we're going to say right up here at the top is y equals 0. So down here is y final is equal to negative 1. So the pattern that you need to recognize is that first we'll find the time of how long is it in the air for, and then we'll multiply the time by this velocity to figure out how far along the floor it is. To find the time, what we're going to use is a kinematic equation of y final is equal to y initial plus the initial velocity in the y direction times time, plus 1/2 the acceleration times the time squared. So again, as I already mentioned, this is all in the y direction. So the initial velocity in the y direction is actually 0. The initial y, as we talked about, it's at y equals 0. So that also goes to 0. So y final is equal to 1/2 the acceleration times the time squared. As we discussed, we want to solve for the time. So first, let's multiply both sides of the equation by 2, or in other words, 2 over 1. So that will cancel out the 1/2. So now we have 2 times y final is equal to acceleration times time squared. Divide both sides of the equation by acceleration. So now we have t squared is equal to 2 times the y final divided by acceleration. We'll take the square root of both sides, of course. So t is finally equal to the square root of 2 times the y final divided by the acceleration. So now to find the time, we'll plug in our values of 2 times the y final we set as negative 1 meter. And then we'll divide that by the acceleration, which in the y direction will only be gravity. So it will be a negative 9.8 meters per second squared. So we have the square root of 2 times a negative 1 divided by negative 9.8 meters per second squared gives us 0.452 seconds. So the time that it's in the air is 0.452 seconds. So that's how long it will take to hit the floor. Now we need to figure out how far away from the edge of the table did it land on the floor. To do that, we're going to take this time because we said already that the x component of the velocity does not change. So for this entire 0.452 seconds, it's going at this speed. So the velocity equation is what we're using, which is a change in the distance over a change in time. We'll rearrange it for this by multiplying both sides by t. So the change in the x is equal to velocity times time. So the distance is equal to the velocity, which we said 1.25 meters per second squared. And then we'll multiply it by the time of 0.452 seconds. So 1.25 times 0.452 gives us a total distance from the edge of the table is 0.565. So it went 0.565 meters from the edge of the table.